गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज एनर्जी स्टोर्ड इन अ कैपेसिटर। ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट द एनर्जी विच कैन बी स्टोर्ड इनसाइड अ कैपेसिटर एंड वेयर एक्चुअली टू स्टोर आउट द एनर्जी और वेयर वी विल डू द वर्क दैट विल बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू एनर्जी। सो वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस। सपोज वी हैव अ कैपेसिटर, पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर वी हैव एंड वी आर चार्जिंग दिस कैपेसिटर। ओके, we are charging this capacitor. Suppose firstly we are giving a charge, positive charge. How we can give the charge? By applying the potential difference. So across this, suppose potential difference is being applied. So when we store the first charge, what is the work done? So students, in electrostatics, whenever we have to calculate the work, we should be well aware about the potential or potential difference. Why? Because we have studied for potential, electric potential, the amount of work done to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to a certain point. So V is equal to W upon Q. So what is W? W is equal to QV. So here this is very clear that work done is depending on potential. So students, when we brought the very first charge, there was no potential present before. So the work done was zero. Now suppose when we brought the second charge by charging it, so we have to do little work. Why we have to do the work? Because now the positive charge will apply a force of repulsion on the next charge. So when we started accumulating this positive charge here, we have to do certain work. And when we are bringing the third charge, we have to again do the work, and that work will be little more. And when we will bring the fourth charge, so we have to do the work against the force applied by these three charges. When we will bring the next charge, again the work done will be more work. So this is how we have to do the work. And finally, the potential which was starting was zero because no potential was present, and it has extended up to a certain value, say V. So finally, the work done will be equal to how much? What is the formula for work done? Q into V. So the work done will be, suppose the charge store is Q, so Q into V. Now because this plate is positively charged, so by the method of induction, this plate will be negatively charged. Fine, so W is equal to QV, and what is the work done initially? Q into 0, so Q into 0, that was 0. So we can say that initial work done was 0 and final work done is equal to QV. So what is the work done totally, which work we have done? So the answer is, we can calculate the average work done. So average is equal to work initial, okay, plus work final divided by 2. This is how we calculate the average. So this will be, initially it was 0 plus QV divided by 2. So work done will be equal to QV upon 2. Okay, now suppose we substitute the value of Q. So what is the value of Q? In place of Q, we can substitute CV. So this will be W is equal to CV into V divided by 2. So W is equal to half CV square. And this work done to accumulate all the positive charges, or in short to charge this particular capacitor, is stored in the form of potential energy. So we can say U is equal to half CV square. So this is the energy stored inside a capacitor. Okay, I hope you understood this. Now this was a mathematical way to do this. Now we will little bit complicate it. Okay, let us complicate this derivation, and we will do it now by the method of integration. So students, we have seen that potential initially was zero and finally it is V. So we can say the potential is changing. Okay, for bringing all the charges, the potential is changing. So we cannot calculate the total work done at a time. So what we should do, in the language of physics, we should calculate it for a very small potential dV. Okay, and when we will calculate this for a very small potential, then work done will be also very small. So that will be dW. So let us let dW, work is done to store a charge Q, okay, when potential is dV. So what will be the value of a small work done? dW. dW is equal to charge into potential, that is dV. Now let us, we have to calculate the total work done to accumulate all these charges. Okay, so we are calculating W, and that will be which operator we should use now? You already know, whenever we are going from a small to many more, okay, then we should integrate this. So W is equal to integration of dW, so is equal to integration of Q dV. Okay students, now initially the potential was zero potential, and finally the potential was V. So we can say we have to integrate it from the lower limit 0 to the upper limit V. So W is equal to 0 to V. In place of Q, we can replace it by Q is equal to CV. So this will be CV dV. So W is equal to, C is a constant. Why C is a constant? I can tell you this. The capacitance of a capacitor, parallel plate capacitor, is given by C is equal to epsilon naught A upon D. Or K epsilon naught A upon D. K is a constant, epsilon naught is a constant, permittivity of the medium, area of cross section remains same, and D between D is the distance between the two plates. So this also remains a constant. So we can say the capacitance is a constant, and this we can take outside from the bracket, okay, or from the integration. So this will be 0 to V, V dV. What is the integration of V? V power 1, x power n is equal to x power n plus 1 upon n plus 1, integration x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So apply the same identity here, so you will get W is equal to C V square divided by 2, okay, and when you will substitute the limit, even minus 0, so this remain similar. So total work done is equal to 1 by 2 CV square, and this is what, this is the work done to accumulate all the charges. So in short, we can say this work done is stored in the form of potential energy. So U is equal to 1 by 2 CV square. This is the energy stored inside a capacitor. I hope you understood this. Thank you. God bless you.